Hello, everyone. Welcome to the podcast. This is Jill. Have you ever wondered how you can meet new people and make new friends? And how can you get yourself out there into the world again? That's what we'll talk about today. Friendship is born the moment when one person says to another, "What? You too? I thought I was the only one." C.S. Lewis, The Four Loves. So there are times in our life where we find ourselves maybe a little bit lonely, maybe not getting enough social interaction, maybe wishing we had more friends or wishing that we could meet a new dating interest in our lives again. And sometimes it's hard to do. Sometimes we don't feel like doing the work that it takes. One of the great things about making friends is it's about getting yourself out there and taking those risks, even if they're tiny little risks, taking chances. And so we'll talk about some ideas about how to get yourself out there. One of the most important things that you have to do is to say yes to things. Saying yes to your coworkers at work, saying yes to going out with friends of friends, saying yes to a new club that you thought about going to for a long time and you just have never done it. Because those new adventures are those new opportunities to get you out there in the world. And meeting new friends is almost one of those percentage things. The more you get yourself out there, the more you do find friends and people to do things with. If you're sitting there in your house alone and thinking about how alone you are or how lonely you are, it's really hard to think that there are a whole world of people out there that might be great for you to meet. Even if they're not your best friend, even if they're not someone that you do something with every day, maybe you're not looking for that. Maybe you're looking for someone to play an occasional game with, or you want to just have someone to chat with you for an evening. It's one of those funny things too, like when you go camping, it's great to just sit there and chit chat with people who walk by your campsite and invite them over to have some marshmallows with you. It can be something just minor like that. If you're just sitting there by yourself and thinking about how alone you are, you will be alone. So start saying yes. Even if you're very shy, you're not the kind of person who goes and talks to other people, you have to step up and try to overcome that. Shyness or even just the desire not to talk to people can have the effect of keeping you alone for a long time. I'm an extrovert. I talk to people all the time. I grew up as an only child, and so my parents would go on these vacations, and I was just alone a lot of the time. And since I was in a strange town, I didn't have any siblings to play with, I just met people. And I think that's what really made me that person I am today, because I would just meet a bunch of kids at the pool and the hotel, and we would start playing games, we'd make up games, and we would just hang out. And it became more fun for me than if I just sat in the corner of the pool room by myself and didn't meet anyone. Trying to get out there and doing those things is really helpful. I also grew up on a military base, which means that people moved all the time. They moved into the base, they moved out of the base, you moved into the base, you moved out of the base. And so I could probably tell you that I had 50 close friends over the course of 8 years because things changed all the time. It was so difficult to really make these long-standing relationships because the nature of being in the military means that you're typically not in the same place for a very long time. So you better get there, make friends, and learn to meet people quickly before one of you ends up moving. Sometimes this is a good opportunity when you're trying to meet new people to volunteer for things. There are a lot of charitable groups that will help other people. And not only does it help you meet other people who like something that you like, because if you're volunteering for something you care about, you get to meet like-minded people who are interested in some of the same things you like to do. So volunteering or going to a political campaign or going to any sort of a social event over can help you meet other people who are like you. Even in my town, which is not that incredibly large, has a ton of meetup groups. There's an actual website that's meetup.com, and they will do everything from hiking groups to biking groups and canoeing, and not even just sports things. It might be painting or people who just like to talk about books. But there's a lot of these websites that are set up to get people together over the same kinds of hobbies. And you can also do research on your own by going to game stores if you like playing games and seeing if they have an open night, if there's some kind of a running club or biking club, if you like doing those kinds of things. There's even travel groups that are out there, bus trips and tours that you can sign up and go on a bus tour or something. And I know sometimes people could seem like that's a thing you do when you retire, but there's a lot of fun people that go on travel tours and trips, and they can be a lot of fun. It's a great way to see something interesting and to be with people who are interested in seeing those things too. There are also a lot of places around town that are escape rooms, pottery paint places, wine and painting, all sorts of different things that you can do that will help you meet people that is just a one-night fun thing. But even if you meet some people who are interested in the same things you are interested in, you might start up a friendship that can last forever because those people are interested in doing some of the things that you're doing. There are a lot of classes that you can take, whether it comes from the university extension. If you live near a campus, there's a lot of classes that are on campus that are free that you can just go to and learn something new. There's a lot of classes that are just around town. We have this thing that's really interesting where it is a craftsman company where they just have all sorts of saws and welding machines and all sorts of things to make stuff. And they have a ton of classes that will show you how to make a name plaque for your house or show you how to make a box for your gardening, whatever it is. But they will teach you those skills. And so when you take a class on welding, you'll see other people who are interested in doing some of the things you're doing. Sometimes work is a great place to meet people socially as well. A lot of people have friends at work, and that might be some work social events. My company has some gaming clubs. Sometimes at dinners, it can even be something like a potluck. There are some of these networking clubs that are after work, and they are meant to get people within a certain industry, like the tech industry or the social services industry, together to talk about common things in their work industry. Those are also great places to meet people who are a little bit like you because they work in a company like you. There are some funny things out there, like the trivia events at bars and restaurants that are fun to participate in. I got onto a bowling league by signing up at the bowling lanes for a team that was looking for a spare person. I did this twice and I found two really great teams. The first was rather funny. It was a foursome couple, a guy and a girl and another guy and the girl that were dating each other, and they were couples and a bowling team, and one of the guys broke up with his girlfriend, and so they were looking for a spare. I came in and was that extra person on the team. It was hilarious because she was a stripper, and at one point, the team said, "You're a much better bowler than the stripper was. We're glad we have you." Well, there's a compliment I've never had in my life before, but okay, great. So it's another good way of meeting people. Fitness classes, book clubs are out there. There's some community gardens that are there. You can go on walking tours of just your hometown or foodie tours. There's a lot of things that you can do to meet other people. There's also some picnics that you can find on places like Nextdoor where your neighborhood is having an event. And you might go there to meet people that live near you. You can always have some sort of a backyard party and invite your neighbors. I had a great pair of neighbors that lived next door to me, and they would always invite me over to come to their party. And someone even suggested that if you want to make a lot of friends, get a dog. If you ever walk a dog in a neighborhood, everyone loves to come up to you and say hi to your dog. And so it's another great way of taking your dog on a walk, going to one of the dog parks, and just talking to other owners. It's a great way of meeting people that you've never met before. And then there's the whole online world. There's online games, there's online chats, there's different ways of meeting people through virtual groups. I have a really good friend, and we met playing video games together. A number of years ago, she saved my life because a giant was chasing me, and she punched the giant out, saved my life, and we have been friends ever since. We started out in the video game world, and then we started doing events in real life. We've been camping together, I've been to her house, she's been to my house. We even did a hike in England together. But over the years, we became friends. I belong to a few other online communities, including a great one at podfeet.com. Allison has a great Slack channel where a lot of people talk about tech topics and fun things that they found on the internet or ask really good questions about different technologies. But it's an online community that really loves each other and loves to get together in person when they can at different conferences, technology events. But you can find a group around a lot of things. Some important things to keep in mind when you're trying to meet new people is, first of all, work on your friendship skills. That means learn how to break the ice. Start small conversations. And everyone hates it. If you tell people that you're going to do small talk, people think it's terrible because they think that these are throwaway conversations that don't matter. And they're not. They're ways of introducing yourself to another person in a way that's not threatening. So you say, wow, it's been really hot today. Yeah, I really don't like the heat. And I haven't liked being outside. I'm trying to find a good way of cooling off. Oh, me too. I don't like the heat either. But you know what I've been doing? I found this great indoor skate rink and I go there and it cools me off. Whatever it is. But even though it's small talk, it was a quick way to introduce yourself to that other person. Say something personal about you. One, I don't like heat. Two, I found a great way to beat the heat. And here's how. And suddenly, now you have two things to talk about. And they grow on from there. But if you never break the ice and you never say hi to another person, those conversations don't happen and you never meet those people. I have people who have been friends of mine for 20 years that I've met at conferences at my work because we started out with small talk. We broke the ice with each other and we became friends. And it's easy enough to do. Make sure that you're confident, that you maintain eye contact, that you smile. But the more people you talk to, whether you're asking for help or just saying something interesting to a stranger, you'll start getting your access out there. And on one hand, you'll start working on your social skills. And on the other side, you might make a friend because you will never make friends unless you talk to other people and find out what's interesting to them. But always remember to introduce yourself, even if you have a small conversation. Oh, do you know where the history books are? Thank you very much. By the way, I'm Jill. And thanks again for showing me the way, because that introduction is the part that will lead to other events. Make sure, too, that you keep your old friends. It's one thing to make a lot of friends. It's a whole other thing when you keep the friends you have and you start making friends of friends. Sometimes your friend will say, well, I'm not really interested in going bowling, but I have a friend who loves bowling and she would love to bowl with you, too. Or I don't really like live music at the bar, but I have a friend who loves it. She has a great list of places she likes to go. So maybe it's not your friend that's going to help you find other people. But the friends of friends will really get you involved in that. And really, when it comes to friends, it's important to seek people out. And if you don't, you'll never find people. One of the funny things about me is I'm kind of a homebody. And then I always think, why don't I meet people? Well, it's because I'm at home. That's why I don't meet people. You got to get out there and you got to do some of these things that will really make you interested. And make sure, too, that you keep an open mind. Sometimes we meet people and immediately we judge. Is this someone I'd like to get to know better? Or is this someone who's just really not my cup of tea? And we're so judgmental about things because we immediately rate people. And I'm not talking about judging whether they're safe or not safe. But what I'm talking about is we might look at someone and see someone and they have blue hair. Or they're someone who's very traditional and you're like to live the wildlife. If you immediately dress people down like that and put them into that box, you might give up a friendship that you didn't know was available to you. And the last piece of advice is don't start feeling bad about this. It is really easy when we are young and we're kids to make friends. We grow up in a particular neighborhood and we have these friends of maybe our parents' friends or people who live in our neighborhood. And then our world starts getting bigger and bigger. We go to a school that's farther away. Eventually, we go to a high school that's even farther away. We may go to college, and we meet people all the time who give us that opportunity to make friends. But what's weird about it is as you get older, it becomes harder to do, and we actually have to work to do it. Our friends don't come to us anymore. And I think that's why there's a lot of articles out there about how people get lonely as they get older. England hired someone who was almost like a cabinet level position on loneliness because they found out that people in England were so lonely that it was affecting people's health. We just don't have friends come to us that easy. As we get older, we may even feel like we don't need anyone. I already have my life. I already have a couple of good friends. I don't need more people in my life. And that's probably the wrong way to look at it. There's always more people that can be in your life in different aspects. You might have a best friend. You may have a spouse. You may have a group of friends you love to have dinner with. But there's nothing saying that you can't have some other friends that you play board games with, or you have a book club with, or you do something else with. That's fine, too. Just get yourself out there. And I know that people get afraid because they feel like they're putting themselves out there. They're afraid of rejection. They're afraid of it being too time consuming or taking over their lives when they're not really looking for it. We worry a little bit like maybe that other person is secretly bad for us or secretly weird and we just don't know it yet, or we're afraid of being taken advantage of. Whatever it is, don't be so afraid and start taking these opportunities to meet other people. It's not lame, it's not scary, and it's something we need to do. Even if you're an introvert or an extrovert, people are a part of your life. Being social is a part of your life, and you need to figure out your way of doing it to get out there. But it all starts with you saying, "Hi, I'm Jill," to other people. Summary: say yes to new adventures, yes to other people, and start saying hi. Introduce yourself. 2, find clubs, sporting events, meetup groups, anything that you can get together with people and start making new friends. 3, keep your old friends and look to the friends of friends, or look to work friends, networking groups, social events, and things you can go to so that you can get to know people better. 4, look for online groups, chat groups, neighborhood groups, things online where you could make friends and even get together with some of those people so that you can actually meet them in real life. 5, go out there, meet people. Don't be afraid. Don't feel like you're going to get rejected, and realize that meeting people takes a little bit more work than it used to. And keep an open mind about people. Find friends who are different religions, different political parties, different from you, have different interests. Some of those friendships are the greatest friendships of all. They give you a different perspective in life and sometimes challenge what you believe. It's not about finding a clone of you. It's about finding someone who can be your friend and giving them a chance. Challenge. Take the small step of talking to people in places at work that you've never met before, or maybe at the grocery store, or someone in your gym. But just say hi and start with small talk and build on that conversation into where that conversation is 1 or 2 steps down the road from where you started, and just get better at it. You're not looking for lifelong friends. You're looking at trying to get better at meeting people and getting to know something about them. And now our fun entertainment advice of the day from Michael Scott in The Office.
Do I need to be liked? Absolutely not. I like to be liked. I enjoy being liked. I have to be liked. But it's not like this compulsive need to be liked, like my need to be praised.
I suppose that's a way of looking at friendships, but I think being more clear and not so desperate, that's a way to go about it. Okay, everyone, thanks so much for listening. Have a great week. Please remember to review the podcast and subscribe.